Mr. Chair.
Lawmakers of the House of Representatives are preparing for possible filing of plunder and malversation charges against officials of PhilHealth. The malversation charges stem from supposed questionable disbursements of the interim reimbursement mechanism funds.
Malinaw na malinaw sa circular number 2220-07 na itong ating IRM ay applicable lamang doon sa mga asuntong o kaso na involving fortuitous event coronavirus. At base sa submission nyo ngayon, pati infirmaries binigyan nyo ng IRM.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
You would be liable already for technical malversation or use of illegal use of public funds.
Deputy Speaker Rodante Marcoleta also pointed out that PhilHealth released IRM funds even before it was legal.
Ito palang IRM took effect legally June 11, 2020. So what happened to the funds that you disbursed prior to this date? What?
Sir, it appears that requirement of the circular was not satisfied as to the requirement to furnish. So it is without authority, it would appear, Mr. Chair.
For Surigao del Norte Representative Ace Barbers, he sees possible charges over PhilHealth's failure to withhold tax from fund releases.
This is another case of malversation. Parang niluto tayo sa sarili nating mandiga eh. Unang-una, nirelease nila yung pondo sa private facilities. Dapat nag-withhold na agad sila ng 2% doon. At itong 2% na to, amounting to 156 million, eh dapat pumasok na sa ating national treasury. Pero hindi nila ginawa yon.
Officials of the state insurer also drew flak over consultancy fees amounting to around 26 million pesos in 2018 and the procurement of supposedly outdated and overpriced desktop computers in the same year. Lawmakers also questioned the qualifications of some high-ranking officials in the agency and recommended that competency standards be updated. They also found fault with PhilHealth for filing few cases for fraud. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.